quite difficult standing here at this side right now. It's really difficult. But of course, we're going to give it a shot and we're going to give it our best. Now, we're all talking about the dharnas. I think we need to brush up our memory a little backwards. There was an episode when the government tried to push them away as well. The PF, the PAT dharna, as well as the PTI dharna, as they call it. There was use of force by the government. But what did the government eventually do? They had to call it, they had to take their orders back. Because then again, it was in the interest of every civilian that there was. We are just raising the debate that the government did this again, just in the interest of public. And believe me, it is in the interest of public. It seems really odd to all of us sitting here. If the 1500 of us go and have a dharna over there, why didn't the government capitulate, like you said, to the demands of PTI or PAT? PAT is also considered to be a religious-minded, extremist sort of a party. They also have the same objectives, quite similar to Tehreek-e-Labbaik, as if I may add. But the difference in these two situations was the government, we should applaud our government, not say that they had to rub their noses, because they learned from an episode of the past and they did not want to escalate it to that point. How is it not in, it was purely in the interest of every person sitting here. How can I say that? Because I speak from the point of view of a common man, not from the point of view of a legal academic right now, but from a simple common man. I experienced it myself. I was expecting my second child and it was the time of the dharna. Trust me, it was a nightmare getting to the hospital. It was a nightmare. We completely forget the fact that there is a vast majority of people out there who have nothing to do with the dharnas, who have nothing to do with how politics or maybe the military or the government runs. They just live day to day and they have to make ends meet. What about the people who work for daily wages? Where do they go? When things like these happen, they don't get paid. How do they put food in their bellies? Who's going to support them? Nobody, not any tehreek, and not even the government. So if the government was conscious this time around to not escalate it to that point, I think we should appreciate our government that they did the right thing. Now talking about, it seems like this debate seems as if we were negotiating with the terrorists. They're also people of Pakistan. I agree, we might disagree with the kind of mindset they have. We might, and we do. That's okay. That is also our constitutional right. We do not have to disagree with everybody that lives in our country. We can do that. But that does not mean we have to completely disregard them as not as being Pakistanis. They also have a right to be heard. Their voice, and most importantly, yes, yes, please.
No.
Please.
Nobody denied their right to be called or acknowledged as Pakistanis. So please don't make that argument.
Okay, I won't, but there was a debate that let's have a dharna and what will happen if we 1500 go there. We'll be beaten. It has got to do something with this. Because
what?
If we talk about the dharnas back in when PTI and PAT had that dharna, there was beating up of civilians back then as well, and also of the forces, casualties of the forces as well. We can't ignore that fact. So if this time around our government has been conscious in taking an initiative earlier to maintain order in a quicker manner, we should applaud them instead of ridiculing them and saying they rub their nose in the mud. I completely disagree.
So it is the democratic right of those hooligans to protest in Islamabad, but it is not the democratic right of students here at LUMS to hear a debate on Balochistan.
Trust me, I do not have affiliations with the Empire ki ungli ya khufiya taqat. I seriously don't understand who they are. But I think we as citizens of Pakistan have the power to change all this. We can make a change. We can actually. It sounds cliche, but we actually can make a change if we try and listen to each other. If the government had heard the point of view of these people earlier on. I'm not saying give in to the demands of someone. I'm saying listen to someone. Because what, no matter how big a conflict or how small, you can wage war on any country you feel like. But what is going to be the end result? Diplomacy. You have to resort to diplomacy. There's no other way forward. That is exactly what the government did. I don't see it like rubbing your nose in the mud. Seriously, I don't. I see it in the interest of all the people in Pakistan. They did the right thing. They were conscious. The elected, for the first time in my political conscious thought, I thought my government did the right thing. They put an end to something which had gone anyways. And definitely in a worst possible way. And look now, we're all back to our normal lives, aren't we all? Aren't we all back to our normal lives? We're debating on it, I agree. But we're all back to our normal lives. This wouldn't have been possible if the government had not intervened in this way. It wouldn't have been possible. So let's have faith in our institutions and not, you know, and another thing, let's say we all have our own opinions about the military as well. But we should also not ridicule them in a way because that is also an institution of Pakistan. Once we will respect our institutions, only then can we comment or expect them to perform to their best. Of course we have flaws, but we're a budding democracy. We've faced dictatorship for so many years. How do you expect these things to change overnight? I don't think so. And another important thing that I might add here, we were saying that, you know, we'll have a nuclear war with India. I don't see that happening. Radiation spreads, so that is not a possibility. Trust me. We are not going to nuke them, and they are not going to nuke us. That's not possible. No. Sir raised the point that, you know, that's how the army makes its bucks. You know, we are going to have a war with India.
They make their bucks by getting the land. 93 acres here given to General Rahil Sharif.
One more
because
time.
They gave because Gadian Road, which is just next to Lums, has been declared agricultural land.
Sir, well, thank you for adding on to my knowledge, but I'm not here to defend military. But yes, we have to keep one thing in mind as well. Why did the government do this? Because we have a very hostile neighbor. We have a very hostile neighbor. The world is watching. What do you want the world to see? How do you want the world to see Pakistanis? We need to come up with a softer image of Pakistan. We can't progress otherwise. And what did the government of Nigeria do when the girls were taken hostage? This wasn't a hostage situation. That was an extreme situation. What did the government of Nigeria do? It's like rubbing nose in the mud? I don't think so. You have to safeguard this is the prime responsibility under the constitution of any country, of the state, to protect its citizens from any sort of harm and to produce a conducive environment where they can survive. I think that's all I would want to say.